In the last video, I got the side pieces attached to the backbone and fitted the lower welder shelf. The top shelf is quite a bit easier to set up. It's flush with the top of the side braces, so I've just clamped a piece of material to the front of it so gravity pulls it down so it's perfectly flush there. And I put a support in the back that holds this so it's absolutely level. I'll put a spacer in the back the same thickness as this piece in the front. And I've checked this with the level, and it's perfectly level. So the next step is I'm going to drill the holes through from the back for the bolts. I have the pilot holes drilled already. I'll make sure this is centered and drill the first hole through. I'll put a cleco in that hole, and now I can drill the second hole. And I'll put a cleco in that. So the back is mounted. Now I need to make the holes for the front. I'm going to use a tool called a transfer screw. This is designed to fit in a 1/4-20 hole, the hole size we tapped in this side piece. I'll screw this into place, put the shelf down where it goes, and then to mark the center of the hole, I just need to tap this side piece, and that will make a mark right in the center where the hole needs to go. So I'll pull this transfer screw out and do the same thing on the other side. Take the clecos out of the back. Now I can open up these holes and I'll be ready to bolt this shelf into place. I'll put the bolts in from the back. Put a nut on the bolt. Get the next bolt into place. And the next nut. Now we can put the front screws into place. It's looking great so far, and I need to make one more shelf for the bottom. I punched holes for mounting the bottom shelf, and I made a chipboard template of the shelf to show the size and shape. So working from this template, I'll make an identical part from sheet metal. I've cut a blank of metal to size, and I'll use a bending break to make the flanges on the front and back edges. It's time to fit the lower shelf into place, and to do so I had to remove a screw to give me a little flexibility here to make space for it. So it slips down in like this. Now I can put that screw back into place. I'll use some spring clamps to hold this flush with the side braces. Now I'll use a transfer punch to mark the center of each hole. So now I can pull this apart and drill these holes. It's time to join the rear axle to the cart now, and rather than weld the axle directly to the cart, I want to weld a sleeve onto the cart so the axle can slip into place. This way, if I ever want to go to a different wheel or a wider tire, I can just change the axle. So I bent up this piece of sheet metal so it's a nice snug fit over the axle. We'll get this fitted into place and hold it tight to the base with clamps. And now I'll put some tack welds on this to hold it into place. I want to try this on the floor now to make sure I'm happy with the wheel layout. So the cart is assembled and I've installed the wheels and everything is moving smoothly. So now I can finish weld the rear axle. Next, I'll mount the bracket that holds the bottles into place on the cart. This bracket I've made has two holes in it, and these align with the screws that hold the top shelf into place. So I'll get this screwed into place and then mark and drill the holes for the bottom two screws. So the bracket's screwed into place, and now I'll mark the holes. Now I'll drill these through with a 1/4-inch drill bit. I need to restrain these bottles so they can't move as I roll the cart around. So I put a threaded stud on this bracket, and I put a knob that can tighten on that shaft. I've mocked up a clamping bracket from MDF, and this size and shape seems to work just fine, so I will duplicate this part from sheet metal. I'm going to make this clamping bracket in a slightly unconventional way. I've taken a piece of 16-gauge sheet metal and bent it into a channel, so it's an inch wide and the flanges are a quarter inch tall. Now I'm going to bend this in a simple fixture. So this fixture just has a notch in it. I slide the channel down into the notch, and it's so easy to bend. And I'll use the drawing to show me where to make the cuts on each part. The first three pieces are fitted perfectly to the drawing, so now I can tack weld these together. I made a simple fixture from MDF to make the S-shaped curve on the back of the bracket. You can see how the parts fit together. I'll put the metal channel on the bottom form, hold the top form in place, and use an arbor press to do the shaping. That does a great job of making the curve on the inside of the bracket. Then I'll use a wrench to give me leverage to make the curve on the outside. I'll flip this around to give you a better view of the other side. So it's pretty easy to make the bends, and I'll try this on the drawing to check the shape. I'd say that looks pretty darn good. I've sanded the welds down smooth on this part, and now it's time to join the two pieces together. And my plan on this is to make a straight cut from this point on all the parts. I have these pieces nicely fitted together now, and I can tack weld them. The alignment looks perfect, so I'll go ahead and finish weld these. Those welds cleaned up beautifully. The next step is to cut the ends at 45 degrees and cap them. I cut the angles on both ends. I'll hold this in a vise for stability. I have pieces of metal cut to the right size, and I'll use a third hand to hold them in place as they're tacked. I've sanded everything smooth on this bracket, and I'm very pleased with how it came out. The next step is to drill the holes for the mounting stud. Let's try this bracket out and see how it works. I'll pull the knob off, slip it into place, tighten the knob, and that holds the bottles very snugly. I'm very happy with how that came out. I'm using a press to seat threaded inserts on each end of the cart handle. The vise holds the handle vertical. The threaded inserts are ready to go. I'll place one insert at the end of the tube and press it home. I'll do the same on the other end. So now it's ready to mount. Let's do a test fitting of the handle. Looks great. I've assembled all the parts for the welding cart. I've just tried the welders into place to check the fit. Everything looks great, so now I can send the parts out to be powder coated. The parts are back from powder coating, and I think they came out great. So it's time to do the final assembly. All the parts are assembled, and there's a couple more details I'd like to add. I've cut some rubber covers for each of the shelves that the welder goes on. These rubber pads will be held in place with carpet tape, and these will prevent the welders from sliding around, and it will also protect the finish. I've also made a cover for the shelf on the bottom from rubber. This just slips into place. And that's good to go. Then I made a cover for this edge. This is just edge protecting material, and it slips into place. It'll keep the powder coating from chipping on that edge. So that's nicely finished. There's a couple more details to finish in the back. I've cut another rubber pad that fits under the gas bottles. So let's get that fitted into place. And then again, I'll cap this edge with a piece of that edge protector. And I'll run this completely around the back edge. That wraps up the welding cart project. I hope walking through the process helps you understand not just how it goes together, but why certain choices make a difference in the final result. If you're building something similar, take your time, think ahead, and enjoy the process. That's where the real satisfaction comes from. Thanks for watching, and if you'd like to keep learning through projects like this, be sure to like and subscribe. Special thanks to my supporters on Patreon. These are the special people who really keep these videos going.